Let me tell you all the story of Roy Bean in all his glory, all the lowest of the Pecos ready sign. We must let our ponies take us to a town in the lower Pecos, where the hybrid spans the canyon thin and fine. He was born one day near Toya, where he learned to be a lawyer, a teacher and a barber and a mayor. He was cook and old shoemender, sometimes preacher and bartender. It cost 2 bits to have him cut your hair. He was right smart of a hustler and a thieving cattle rustler. At mixing up an eggnog he was grand. He was clever, he was merry, he could drink a Tom and Jerry. On occasion at the roundup took a hand. Though the story isn't funny, there was once he had no money, which was for him not very strange or rare. So he went to help Pap wind it, but he got so absent-minded that he put his RB brand on old Pap's there. And as Pap was mighty angry, Roy Bean went down to Langley, where he opened up the office and the store. There he'd sell you drink or buttons or another rancher's muttons, though the latter made the other fella sore. Once there came from Austin City a young dude reported witty. Out of Beanie sort of guest he'd take a rise. And he got so mighty frisky as he up and called for whiskey, saying, "Bean, now hurry up, gold darn your eyes." Then the dude threw down $10 and the bill Bean quickly collars. Yeah, he holds on to 9 and hands back 1. So the stranger gave a holler as he saw that single dollar. At that began the merriment and fun. Oh, the dude, he slammed the table just as hard as he was able. That old boy, he had something up his craw. Said Bean, "For all that fussin' and your most outrageous cussin', you are fined the other dollar by the law." "On this place I own a lease, sir. I'm the justice of the peace, sir. The lowest of the Pecos all is here. And you've acted very badly." Then the dude he went off sadly, while down his lily cheek there rolled a tear. So you boys have heard the story of Roy Bean in all his glory. He's the man who was the justice of the law. He was handy with his hooks, he was ornery in his looks, and no man ever